Hi students, welcome to the next session of identifying the weakness. In the last sessions we were discussing about who is a weakness, what is the importance of a weakness, and what are the types of weaknesses, and we also talked about what are the procedures for the examination of a weakness in a court. So next we will see how to identify and locate a weakness. Some weakness may self-present or be self-evident, whereas other weaknesses may be more difficult to identify and locate. So that investigator must develop clear intelligence-led objectives for identifying the weaknesses. So these are some of the methods for identifying and locating weaknesses, such as viewing CCTV. So CCTVs may be like now in all areas, CCTV coverage is there, and while entering the crime scene, or if a crime occurred, the police officer, the investigating officer, can go and check the CCTV for identifying the suspect or identifying the victim. Then he can seek the help of media, like media appeals, then house to house inquiries, interviews with victims and other witnesses, then suspect interviews, then open source internet search tools. Social media is helping a lot for this purpose, then anniversary appeals. So these are some of the methods for identifying and locating weaknesses. Then interview. What is an interview? Interview is to question or converse with victim, witnesses, complainants and informants in order to obtain some information. So it's a conversation with a purpose. The manner in which the investigator approach witness from the point of initial contact during the interviews and through the other conclusions of any subsequent prosecution cases can have significant bearing on their perception of how the criminal justice system operates. So the investigating officer should be very careful while doing the interview or while contacting the witnesses. Inappropriate or ill-considered methods of dealing with weakness may hamper the investigation and delay or prevent the supply of irrelevant material to the investigation. So that they have to take so many steps while or during the investigation of a weakness. The timely interviewing of a weakness is crucial to the solution of a crime. Weakness to crimes must be identified, sequestered, questioned at the scene if applicable, and processed according to the departmental regulations. Interview any witness at the scene separately to be best use their reported experiences to benefit the overall investigation. And the investigating officer should obtain written or recorded statements from each witness at the police station and transport each witness to the police station separately from other witnesses or suspects. Means the timely interview of the witness is crucial to the solution for a crime. So by getting the information, by gathering the information from the witness, the investigating officer will get a lead for the further investigation processes. So if possible, in the crime scene only, the witnesses has to be identified, and then they has to be sequestered, and if possible, do the interviewing at the scene of crime only. And while doing the interviewing the witness, whatever information they are giving, the investigating officer should remember to write or record the statements given by the witness, because there is a chance of altering the words of the witness. If sometimes he will tell something in front of the police officer, and while in the court, may the chance of changing the words of him is there. So that for an evidence, the investigating officer, what he should do is that he should record the statements. Then while doing the interview, all the witnesses should be interviewed separately. So what the purpose of this is that maybe they can tell if they are together, maybe they will tell the same things. maybe the false informations. But if we interview the person separately, we can, the investigating officer can link the answers given by them. So for that reason only, they have to be separately questioned. And the same case, while transporting the witness to the police station, they have to be transported separately. This is why means they should not exchange the words, and they should not make up any stories regarding this. If they are making like a story regarding the event, if they think separately, they will tell separate things. But if they actually see the crime scene, if they actually saw what has happened there, they can tell only one thing only. Otherwise, they will, the contradiction will be there with both of their words. For that reason only, they should be questioned separately, and they should be transported to the police station separately. And then we told that the interviewing of the witness is a crucial thing in the investigation purpose. So what is the purpose of interviewing? Why it is so crucial? It's that by interviewing, the investigating officer can gather facts objectively without any bias and discover leads towards new evidence, motives, witness or suspect, establish link with connect or verify facts supplied by different people or facts learned in previous questioning of the same, and discover the truth. So by interviewing the witness, the investigating officer will get the actual truth about what has happened there on that particular time or particular event, and what are the facts behind the crime, and he will get some new evidence, or he will get the suspected person, and from his the information given by the witness, the investigating officer can link the events with the suspect, and they establish a link with connect or verify facts supplied by different people. There may be two or three witnesses, so from the answers or from the information given by these two, three witnesses, he can link and connect to the new person or to the suspect, or to the he will get new evidences about the crime, and finally to discover the truth. And when interviewing a witness at a crime scene, the interviewing investigator can encourage details by asking follow-up questions such as, and then what happened, or how can you be sure that this is what you remember seeing or hearing. And these kind of questions encourage the witness to find the details in within their own memories of the incident. So maybe the event occurred in some other time, and after 2 or 3 days the investigating officer is, or after 1 month the investigating officer is interviewing the witness, or in the court. So in such cases, if like follow-up questions such as these kind of questions, if they ask to the witness, they can retain their memory, old memories. Then in some cases, anniversary appeals will be there. So the crime had occurred maybe 1 year or 2 year back, and after 1 or 2 years, the witness appeared in front of the police officer, and at that time he should remember all the things what has happened earlier, what has happened 1 or 2 years back. So that the questions, the interviewing person should encourage the witness to find the details from his memories. And leading questions can alter the information witnesses present. So we know what is a leading question in examination in chief, like recording the evidences in the court. I told you about the leading question. So this can alter the information witnesses present. So leading questions would point to information the witness may not have, or cause witnesses to recall inaccurate details that support what the investigator is saying or asking for. So it is extremely important for crime scene investigator to avoid jumping to conclusion before gathering the information. So that the investigating officer should only encourage the person if he jump into the conclusion and he is asking some kind of leading questions, that will alter the answer of the witness. So for getting the correct information, the investigating officer should not jump and he should not ask such kind of questions. What he should do is that the investigating officer or the interviewer must hear all the information what the witness is telling, and after hearing all those evidence, all those information, then only he should obtain some conclusion. He should make some conclusions regarding the crime. And if he is jumping in such a way, this can lead the investigator bias, and in which the investigator is only seeking information that confirms their suspicion. So in the crime scene reconstruction also, I told you people about the objectivity. So they should avoid this objectivity, and there should not be any prejudice or bias about the thing. They can assume any things, but he should gather all the information. After gathering all the information, such as the witness information or physical evidence or all this information, he should link everything. Then only he should come to a conclusion. So objectivity is the key to solid, accurate police investigation. So investigation is the key of the accurate police investigation. As the time is not permitting, let me end here, and we will continue the same session in the next class. So thank you.